One of the things we like to do with Chris, he always gives us great tips, but you know, you really, it means nothing unless you go out and take pictures. So what we like to do every month is give you an assignment, give you 4 weeks to fulfill the assignment, and then put your pictures up on the Tech Guy group on Flickr to illustrate that assignment. And then every month we'll take a few pictures and take a look at them. And I know it's a little weird to talk about pictures on the radio, but to explain why these are interesting and so forth. Now, this month's assignment, the task was to illustrate the word or concept language.
Yeah, and I really like what came back. People sent in pictures of signs, and some were like of multilingual signs, and some used coins from different countries to illustrate the word, and it was a crossword puzzle. Someone's even sent in a page of programming language, which is language too. Morse code, kind of more of an alphabet than a language. Even one picture about body language. So I really like how people look at those terms from all different sides. They think outside the box, and that really works well on these assignments. So we have three that I want to take a quick look at.
Yeah.
The first is by Southern Pixel Albie. And
I love this one.
Well, if you read the note, it's 15-month-old Nola Marie learning American Sign Language as a second language.
So she speaks. So she's not deaf, but she is learning ASL.
Yes.
And but that's really kind of cool, because 15 months is really at the beginning of any language acquisition.
Right.
And it's so cute.
And it's not just the cute pictures and the whole topic that it's about, but I just like the way of the presentation, because people always look like, okay, this is one picture. But if you put pictures together in, let's say, in a diptych of two pictures, or a triptych, or even four pictures, you can really tell a different story. So presenting pictures this way is really a nice way to help multiple pictures tell one story.
Albie's taken four different pictures, captioned each with the word that she's speaking, and put them in a single frame. You know, there are apps to do this on the iPhone and the iPad, and on sites like Instagram. You see a lot of people using frames and framing. And I think it is a kind of a neat way to make a single picture tell a story. It's almost like a comic book. So she's saying food by touching her lips, please by touching her heart, yum. I don't know what yum is, just by eating, I guess. And thank you by touching your lips. And it's really neat. I really like that. I like good choice. So thank you, Albie, for submitting that one.